What's up, guys? Charles here. You don't need the latest laptop or the newest Intel Z890 board to take advantage of Thunderbolt 5 technology. Although this standard was announced over a year ago and has seen limited integration and availability, this new product has the potential to change that quickly. There are several concerns with Thunderbolt 5, one of which is the lack of platform support and lack of Thunderbolt 5.0 devices. Even when you upgrade, there is still a question of why. So far, there are no 5.0 external GPU enclosures, which is perhaps the biggest reason for GPU enthusiasts to consider this standard. However, Thunderbolt 5 offers much more. It will enable much higher speeds. And what makes it better than Oculink is not just the speed, but also its compatibility with a compatible USB Type-C cable. Thunderbolt 5, actual name, is a PCIe 4.0x4 add-in card that uses a single slot. This card is not a low-profile design and uses dual 6-pin power connectors. This is necessary because the card supports power delivery 3.1 up to 100 watts, allowing you to power and use devices, such as monitors, through these connectors. Intel Thunderbolt 5 is a promising standard with the potential to replace Thunderbolt 4 and perhaps even Oculink for external graphics card solutions. The bandwidth it offers is much greater, reaching up to 80 gigabits per second in two directions, or even 120 gigabits per second in a single direction, 2 to 3 times more than Thunderbolt 4. Unfortunately, support for Thunderbolt on Intel Z890 motherboards is almost non-existent. Only a handful of designs have been announced with Thunderbolt 5, but at least the previous 4.0 standard is becoming a common feature, thanks to the integration of the controller into the chipset. It is worth noting that Thunderbolt 5 JHL9580 controllers cost $19, which is $8 more than Thunderbolt 4. According to Unico's hardware, Gigabyte has yet to confirm the pricing for Thunderbolt 5, and we couldn't find it available at any stores either. It should work with all PCIe 4.0 motherboards, but Gigabyte has not confirmed this yet, as the page lacks specifications or a compatibility list. That's it for today's video. Do consider subscribing for all the latest content on gaming, and as always, I'll see you at the next one. Peace out.